All right, greetings everyone. Master Chief VerHulst and I are here at the Coast Guard Museum on board the campus of the United States Coast Guard Academy. Our intent today is to give you an update on where we've been this summer and to lay out the plan for the fall and to also thank everyone for all of their efforts and energy over the past 6 months as we've dealt with this pandemic, the racial injustice our nation has seen, and the preparation and support of our Corps of Cadets. So I'm going to start and then I will kick the microphone over to Master Chief. Great. Well, thank you again for joining us. And as we prepare for Coast Guard Day on August 4th and celebrating our Coast Guard's birthday, we thought this would be a fitting place to speak to you about where we've been and where we're going. So our summer training is going great. Our first class and third class have been here through the Academy, tested and ROMed, and then out to the fleet. Many of them are on Eagle right now, and many more are across the Coast Guard serving side by side with our shipmates in the fleet. Our second class and fourth class are SWABs. Are on board the Academy and they're conducting SWAB summer. And by all accounts, our class of 2024 is doing just great. And they're about halfway through and they'll be continuing to push forward under the guidance of our SWABs. I did want to let you know we've done about 2,600 tests for COVID-19 this summer. We've had 8 positives. And so that those results are great. They're indicative of the efforts that we're putting in to ensure that we are safe and ensuring that we're taking care of the well-being of all of our shipmates here on campus. We will continue testing as we go into the fall. We're working on a surveillance testing and a diagnostic testing process. And we'll have more information on that as we get up to full operating capability on that. And our goal is to have that in place prior to the return of the Corps of Cadets. And that's gonna happen the weekend of 15 August. We're gonna stagger the return of our first class and third class. And they'll be receiving more information on that directly from the Commandant of Cadets. And obviously our second class and fourth class are on board. And then we'll move into CAP week, which is a preparatory week for the start of the academic year. And then the first set of classes will begin on the 24th of August. And we'll run straight through until the 24th of November, which is the Tuesday before Thanksgiving. And our intent is to then send the Corps of Cadets home over Thanksgiving break and then keep them home. And allow them to finish up the last 10 days of the academic year remotely. Our faculty and staff are preparing for that, and our cadets will be well positioned for that. We will also make accommodations for cadets who cannot fully participate in the virtual experience, the remote experience. We'll ensure that they're safe and they're able to continue their experience here on board the Academy for those final 2 weeks. But again, more information to come on that, and cadets can engage one-on-one with their company officers, their company chiefs, and their academic advisors with regards to that. In the classroom, what's it going to look like? I think, you know, if you watch what the nation's dealing with, we're all trying to figure that out. We've mapped out each and every one of our classrooms, each and every one of our large spaces here on board the Academy. And so we'll be going with a very hybrid solution. Many students will be in the classroom. Many students will be learning virtually as their faculty present the information online. And then there'll be a mix. There'll be some students that'll be in the classroom, some students that'll be back in the barracks, in the library, or across the 103 acres, taking in the course, and then flip-flopping back and forth. So again, our students will get more information on that. But our intent is to have our Corps of Cadets here, and our faculty and staff, our coaches and crew have been working in that direction. You know, I talked about our coaches. Athletics, you've probably seen the notification that the new MAC conference has canceled all fall athletics. And that's, we're bummed out about that. And I'm certain our student athletes are as well. But here's what I can tell you, is that we will be practicing. And the only thing that we're going to be missing out on is that competition that we so enjoy. And it's such a critical part to our development of leaders of character. So we're going to ensure that we continue the athletic practices, preparing for what we hope will be a winter season, and then hopefully a spring season. And then we're leaving out the opportunity there in the new MAC to potentially move some of the fall sports into the spring. Again, more information to follow on that. You know, there's going to be an opportunity to probably reinvigorate our intramural sports here on board the Academy. We will be doing that, and Dr. Rose and his athletic staff are already looking at how we can do more intramurals and charge up the Corps of Cadets for a little friendly competition between companies, and we'll be working on that in the fall, and we'll be looking to see. I'm sure Paul Duddy will be getting some great pictures and pushing those out to you. You know, folks have asked a lot about Liberty. Are our cadets going to be able to get off campus? And our cadets will be able to get off campus, but they're going to have to mask up. They're going to have to do the right things. This is going to rely solely on our cadets to do the right thing and emulate what we expect as from a humanitarian service like our Coast Guard to go out there and do the right things. I really think we're going to be relying a great deal on our cadets and our faculty and staff and our coaches and crew who get to go home every night to continue to do the right things in their community so that we maintain the safety and well-being of our community here on board the Academy. And Captain Ray, our new Commandant of Cadets, he has a solid Liberty plan in place, and he'll be sharing that with the cadets as they prepare to come back to campus. But rest assured, our cadets will have the opportunity to get off and do what all of us are able to do. Mask up, eat outside, visit a store if we need to, get the things we need to do, recreate, and then come back to campus to do what they need to do. I will say we're investing heavily through support from our Alumni Association in some of the facilities here on campus. We're going to be decking out our patio off Leamy Hall. I'm sure many of you have said, hey, why don't you do something better with that space? It's a pretty large space overlooking the lower field, overlooking the football field. So our Alumni Association, through generous donations from the class of 61 and others, we're already invested in buying some furniture and some patio outlay and some awnings and TVs and the whole thing. So that's one of the positives that's going to come out of this whole situation is we're going to have a much better space for our cadets to recreate in. And then, you know, admissions. They just knocked out a great virtual AIM. We were able to engage with 700 young women and men from across the country that are interested in our Coast Guard Academy. And the response to virtual AIM was outstanding, not only by the virtual AIMsters, but also by our cadets and our faculty and crew who are involved with it here on board the campus. So, you know, that's another thing we're going to see us do more of in the future. We're obviously going to have our onboard AIM experience, but we're going to be able to continue our outreach further through virtual outreach through AIM and other things like that, that again, we're learning as we go through the process. So, you know, I'm sure there's folks out there that are interested in coming and visiting our academy. There's, you know, high school juniors and seniors that want to learn more about the academy. And what I would offer to you is stay engaged with your coaches, stay engaged with the admissions partners, stay engaged with our admissions staff, and we'll let you know how you can do that safely so that we can get you here. I'm going to talk a little bit more about some other things as we wrap up here. But what I want to do now is I want to kick it over to Master Chief. He and I have both been watching how our crew and our faculty and staff have been engaged, and our cadets, really, the entire community on board the 103 Acres have been doing an outstanding job, and Master Chief's been right down there on the deck plates with them every step of the way. I want to give him an opportunity to chat a little bit. So, Master Chief.
So, thank you, Admiral. I appreciate that. Hey, everybody. Brett VerHulst, the Command Master Chief here at the Academy. I just have a couple things I want to pass. Kind of foot stomping what the Admiral was talking about. Number one, a big thank you to the entire faculty, staff, and crew, coaches, everyone that's been involved in keeping the trains running during this whole pandemic. Behind the scenes, maybe not always getting the accolades or the visibility that they should. So in particular, you know, I think about our IT staff who's gone above and beyond. I think about our public affairs specialists who have been doing a number of events like this with the Admiral and I and numerous others on weekends, after hours, I mean, you name it. Certainly our SPO, cadet admin, when you talk about, you know, our CGPD, I mean the entire workforce, the band has been doing a lot of stuff virtually, and I want to thank them for keeping us engaged. We're going to do a concert event tomorrow, or tonight actually, for the SWABs. I'm looking forward to participating in that. So really want to, and obviously the faculty who have been doing a number of things behind the scenes, preparing for this hybrid solution that we're going to have in the fall. And I'm sure there's folks I'm leaving out, I apologize for that, but please know that your efforts are being seen. Company officers, chiefs, right up there on the deck plate, thank you, folks. So in addition to the thank yous, I also want to make sure that we foot stomp health and safety, because that is still the number one priority here. And you heard the Admiral talk about things like surveillance testing and some of the things that we're going to be pursuing moving forward. Gang, this is an iterative process, okay? We're all learning as we go. We're trying to take in all the inputs from the CDC, from the big Coast Guard, from ForceCom, who's doing some things at Cape May, the other session point. We're trying to roll that all in, and then we're trying to pursue increased capability, and that's what this surveillance testing is going to provide. All right, it will be for the entire crew and staff, as well as the cadets, okay? I want to make sure you know that we are aware of the testing need. And I know that that plays into mental health, all right? I know that plays into a number of factors that impact our safety and where we're at work and that feeling of comfort and belonging. We're all very, very aware of that, okay? And then the other thing I would say is, you know, keep on keeping on, all right? Keep fighting. This is completely new, but we're going to get through it. And we're going to figure out new and better ways to do things. And you know what? We're going to take some of those with us. You know, the Admiral and I have been talking a lot about, you know, writing these things down, right? Annotating what we're doing well during this pandemic. And then making this a better academy in the future for every single person on the 103 acres. And that includes our partners and our friends at the Leadership Development Center as well. So I don't really have much else to pass beyond that other than to say, model the way. All right, and this goes for cadets, it goes for everyone, but please be wearing these. All right, please follow the guidelines that have been published. Okay, please make sure you're social distancing, both here on campus and in the community. We are going to place an enormous amount of trust in the cadets, right? You tell me all the time, folks, that you want to be adults and you want to be treated like adults. Here's your chance. Okay, we're going to give you that autonomy, we're going to give you that trust. So please earn it. Okay? And then to the crew and the faculty and staff, I'd ask that you model the way as well when it comes to health and safety. Thank you very much, and I'm going to turn it back to the Admiral for some closing comments.
All right. Thank you, Master Chief. I appreciate those comments and those words. And I would say probably one other group, as I was just reflecting on Master Chief's comments, is medical. They have done a phenomenal job knocking it out of the park and really changing the way we did day one. We learned a lot once again, and just a thank you to everybody, both on the campus and off, completely up and down the chain of command. Everybody's done a great job, and so much of so much support from our parents and our alums and friends of this wonderful institution. So let me just finish up by saying, you know, a lot of people said, sir, why are you bringing the Corps of Cadets back if some people are not going to be in the classroom, some people are going to be in the classroom? You can't do athletics, you can't do, you know, other things that we naturally do around here, we normally do around here, and make this place special and different. And I would submit to you that we are stronger together. And that together means on board the 103 acres, and it might mean through a medium like this, where a faculty member is engaging with a student at 2300, going over the paper, reviewing the capstone project. Our faculty, our staff, our coaches, our crew, our cadets are learning how to interact through these mediums. And it's what we have to do right now. It's how we have to get through so that we can accomplish the mission. And we must remain focused on our mission. Our mission is to graduate leaders of character for service to our nation and the United States Coast Guard. And that's what we will continue to do day in and day out. We will remain focused on that as we remain focused on the health and well-being of our entire community. And folks, I just want to finish up by saying we are a humanitarian service. We are the world's best Coast Guard. And we are going to ask you to do the humanitarian thing. We're going to ask you to socially distance. We're going to ask you to wear your mask. We're going to ask you to be conscious of your shipmates. We're going to ask you to be conscious of your classmates. We're going to ask you to be conscious of your teammates. We're going to ask you to be conscious of the faculty, staff, and crew that you have the privilege to interact with day in and day out. And one of the ways we can start by doing that is by wearing our mask. And I wear my mask to and from work. I wear it around the campus, and I will continue to do that. So I am confident, I am excited to get the Corps back on board and to see what we do over the 92 days that are going to run from 24 August to 24 November. Because I know you have the capability to do it, and I look forward to doing it with you. I look forward to the opportunity and the privilege to serve with you, and I am privileged and honored to be your superintendent. So thank you for the opportunity to engage with you through this message. As Master Chief said, thanks to the PA staff for making this happen, and I wish each and every one of you the best Coast Guard day possible. Semper Paratus and forever. Go Bears!